Hello everybody and welcome to CNATT channel. In this video, we'll show you how to backup data without booting into Windows 11. At times, we come across Windows boot issues that prevent us from booting into Windows. In this situation, computer data remains inaccessible but intact on the hard disk or SSD storage. If your computer doesn't boot due to a corrupted Windows operating system rather than a hardware problem, before you try to fix them or reinstalling Windows, you may want to backup your documents, pictures, music, and other data. While there are advanced methods and third-party software for data backup, not everyone is comfortable using them. So in this tutorial, we're going to show you a smart way to backup Windows drive data and other drives to a USB drive when you can't boot into Windows. When reinstalling Windows, files stored on drive partitions other than the C drive remain intact. As a result, there is no need to backup data from other drives unless you suspect that there is a problem with your computer's hard drive or SSD. To backup your personal files, you can use an external storage drive such as an external SSD or external HDD or USB flash drive. Step 1. Access the command prompt from the Windows recovery environment. There are several ways to access the Windows recovery environment. In the other videos linked above and in the description, we introduced you to the Windows recovery environment or Windows RE and 6 ways to access it. In that tutorial, methods 4, 5, and 6 are used when Windows doesn't boot properly. If you have access to Windows installation media, use it to enter Windows recovery environment. If you have created a USB recovery drive according to the previous tutorials, use it to enter the Windows recovery environment. If you don't have either, use the physical power button to enter Windows recovery environment. In this tutorial, we'll use Windows installation media to enter Windows recovery environment. Turn off your computer. Connect the Windows installation USB flash drive to enter the Windows recovery environment and another USB drive for backup to the available USB ports. Turn on your computer. You can use other Windows installation media such as DVD instead of USB flash drive. Immediately press the boot menu key on your keyboard. Select the USB flash drive to boot. The keys that are generally used to open the boot menu are Escape, F2, F8, F10, or F12, depending on the computer or motherboard company. Additionally, if your PC doesn't support the separate boot menu, you can use the Del key to access the system BIOS or UEFI and change the boot priority manually. In the Windows Setup page, select Language and Keyboard Input Method, and then click the Next button. Now select Repair your computer. You will see Windows recovery environment. Select Troubleshoot. In the Advanced Options, select Command Prompt. A Command Prompt window will open. Now we go to the next step. Step 2. Backup data. In the command prompt window, type notepad.exe and press Enter key to launch Notepad application. Once the application is launched, click on the file, then open. This will open a mini explorer that you can use to locate folders or individual files needing rescue. Click on the This PC icon in the left pane and then browse to the drive or folder that you want to backup and then copy your files to a USB drive. To view all files, select All Files in File of Type drop-down menu. The Send to function in the context menu may not work. You may need to copy and paste required files onto the USB drive manually. For example, we copy documents and desktop from user folder to external USB drive. Please note that there will be no progress bar during the copy and the PC will appear to be frozen. You just have to wait for it to unfreeze as soon as the copy is finished. After copying, press the F5 key on your keyboard to view the data copied on the external USB. Finally, close all open windows and select turn off your PC. Now you can safely remove the USB drives. In another video that we linked above and description, we'll show you how to factory reset or reinstall Windows. Thanks for watching the video. You can see more tutorials on our channel.